Hello, my friends. Today we will talk about this beautiful kit. We have here four colors of Italian viscose, and I already made one of my favorite elements, flower talisman 6 petals, that I have in my first crochet magazine, JT House, issue 1. And we have here, yes, I used all these colors, and you can see how it looks. Really interesting, gorgeous result. It's very soft, silky, shiny. I ironed and straight this element, and you can see now how beautiful is this motif. For my work, I used small steel hook in size 1.75 millimeters, and now I want to make sample of lace from these four colors, and step by step I will change colors. I will show you one time or two times how to add new color, yes, and you will see how easy you can work with this fantastic thread. So let's start. We will start from the most light color is pastel yellow, next will be dusty pink, after this one beautiful pink, and intensive pink purple thread. So let's take first thread. We will take three balls and join together three threads and start to make first row. My name is Julia Tushnitska. I am founder of JT House Crochet School. I have created several crochet courses about making tablecloths, topolina, dress dream, about beautiful skirt Quincy, about cocktail dress Martinica and dress Lille, also about dress Beverly with long sleeves, about evening dress Amelie and Angelica, and even created crochet course about Cod Spring. All of these crochet courses you will find at jthouse.net. So for first row, I took three threads in the same color, this yellow pastel thread, and I made first row looks like this. It's very soft, shiny, silky, tender, and looks really gorgeous. And now I can join new colors. So, like you know, I am working with three threads. You can see these three threads right now. And I need to cut one thread and I will join new color, this dusty pink thread. So I already cut by scissors one thread and we have here such tail around 25 centimeters. Now I will take new color, new thread. By fingers I will hold all these four threads together. Just you need to take this new color and make tail at the right side around 20-25 centimeters, leave like this. After, by fingers, hold all these four threads. Next, make yarn over, take this all four threads and draw through working loop first time and second time, yes? Now we need to draw all these four threads to the right side. In this way, we will see yellow tail now at the right side. Yes, we see it. Now we need to leave this tail at the left side. This will be yellow one. And move back. Just make smaller this working loop. And now everything is great. We have again three threads, but this time we have new color. Yes, two yellow and one dusty pink. And now I can continue to work with new colors like this. Very easy. And you can see we have one tail yellow at the right side and one tail at the left side is dusty pink. Everything else is like this. We can continue and without any knots I joined new thread and everything is very understandable, easy to do. So now you know how to work with this thin thread. After I will make new row and step by step we will change colors and we will use all these beautiful colors from this kit. And now we have such result. I made next row by using two yellow threads and one dusty pink. In this moment I will change again colors. I will join new dusty pink color, just second skein. So for this I cut yellow thread. We have tail here around 25 centimeters or 30. And now I need to take a new thread. I will join by fingers this four threads together and first loops I will make with four threads. So we have three threads working, yes. Join new one and just by fingers join together four threads. Place this new tail, new color at the right side around 20-25 centimeters. Next, make yarn over, just take all four threads around your crochet hook and draw through working loop. Yes. And you can do like this two times. After you need to draw these all threads to the right side. Till you see this tail, yes, that we just cut out, just at the left side. Next you need to move back, and just you will have this tail now at the right side and one tail of new thread at the left side. And now in my working loop I have three threads, one yellow and two dusty pink. And in this easy way I can continue to work, but now I have new combination of colors. Yes. So you don't need to make knots, just join together few threads, make few chain loops, and that's all. And you will have these tails that you will hide when you will have ready lace. You will hide them by using a needle with big eye in the in the middle of the stitches that you will have in the lace. So now I will make next row by using this new combination of colors. Step by step I used dusty pink threads, and now I have three the same dusty pink threads here. And during next few rows I will use new color, this very beautiful pink thread. I will start from next row and join now one pink thread. For this I already cut one dusty pink thread, and I need to place new thread together with three threads, and by fingers I will hold all these threads together. And we need to leave tail of this new thread at the right side around 25 centimeters. Now make yarn over and draw all these four threads through working loop one time, and after second time to be sure that we will join everything, and second time. Now we have four threads on the hoop. Draw to the right side till we see the tail. Okay, I can see the tail, it's here. Now move back, make smaller these three threads, and we will have working loop with three threads. This tail will stay at the right side, and this beautiful pink thread tail will stay at the left side. And now I can work with three threads. We have now two dusty pink threads and one pink thread. I will show you now better. You can see new working thread, one pink and two dusty pink. And very easily without knots I join its threads, and I can make a new row by using this new beautiful color. Step by step during next rows I will add second cone, next third, and after I will show you how I will join first ball in this very intensive color. So let's work. Now in this moment I finish it to work with this beautiful light pink thread. Step by step I change it colors, and now I will start to work with the last color, this very intensive and beautiful one. So I have three threads in the same color, it's a light pink, and now I can join this intensive thread. Like always I will join by fingers, I will take four threads right now, leave tail of this new thread at the right side, and I need to make two loops together, four threads. So yarn over, make first loop with four threads, again yarn over and make second loop. Now I will draw all these four threads to the right side till I see this tail. Yes, we have tail. So now I will move back, and just by fingers you need to separate this tail, and we have two tails, new color at the left side and this light pink that I cut at the right side. And working threads, we have now three threads, two light pink and one intensive pink. And now very easily I can continue to work. This row I will make with new combination of colors. Next row I will join second ball, and after I will join the last ball and work, and I will work with three threads in the same intensive pink color. And I will finish sample of this lace and show you the result. And now you can see the result, really fantastic lace, sample of lace made with transition of colors by using these four incredibly beautiful colors that we have here in this set of Italian viscose. This lace is very soft, silky, shiny, really beautiful. So this was presentation of this new lace. I used four colors of Italian viscose and created this really fantastic lace. It's really interesting to work with different colors and create transition of colors. And you can create really fantastic projects by using different colors. Just use your imagination and create what you like. Thank you so much for your attention and see you at the next video.